Okay, it is September 14th, and we are at Nisbet Forest. Got Corey and Kim with me, and we're off for a ride. An excellent day of riding at Nisbet Forest. This is the second trailer we've seen go by with quads on them. So I have a feeling, it's Saturday today, and I have a feeling we're going to run into a lot of quadders. So it'll be the first time for me, because... Good, how are you?
Good.
We normally don't run into anybody out here. So our first stop, our destination is going to be a little lake, and probably have lunch down there. And it's supposed to be sunny and 18 to 20 degrees today. It is pretty dry in the Nisbet Forest. These roads are just dry and dusty. Oh, what we got here? Oh, this is the old cabin. Cool. Oh, so this is called Narrows Road. That's why Corey was saying that. All right. So there's an actual sign that says Narrows Road. That's why you were calling it that. Yep. Oh, I didn't know that. Yep. So this...
Roads are... When I bought that chip, they're all on here, on my GPS now.
Really?
Yeah.
So this is going to the lake?
Miles this way, and then we're at the lake.
How far?
4 miles, 3 miles.
Oh, that's not bad. Right on. So this trail is new to me. I've never been on this trail, and I've never been down to this lake. Corey and Kim found this end of last year, I think. They've been telling me about it. Finally, they're taking me down there. What the hell? That's not even that old.
Ford Explorer. There's a good engine, transfer case, transmission.
You gotta be kidding me. So, like somebody rolled their vehicle in here? Or, you know what this is? This is a stolen vehicle. Because you don't just bring it, you wouldn't leave it in here. Even if you rolled it in here, you'd still drag it out for parts and stuff. Could get something for it. I'm surprised nobody's come in here and stripped it.
I think there's something missing. There's a can of WD-40 laying around here. Somebody got something off it.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, it's probably a late 90s maybe, eh?
Yeah. Yeah, it's like it's fairly new. I gotta give you lots of space. It's so dusty. Oh. dead marten. Yeah, I'm thinking that's a marten. He's got a little white underneath his chin. I don't know. I'm not really sure about these weasel family. It's not a weasel for sure. It's either a ferret, and I'm not sure which ones are common to this area. So it's either a ferret. I think martens are a little bigger. That looked more like a ferret. Or a mink. It's probably, maybe a mink. That's probably what it is. In fact, yeah, that's the ticket. It's a mink. We're settling on that. Good, how are you?
Good.
So when we were coming here this morning on the highway, there was a pretty strong wind. And of course, it's got to be against us. And now, there's just absolutely no wind. Go ahead. And all the dust is just hanging. Well, there's the lake. Wow, this is awesome. Some other quarters in here. Yeah, see ya. Man, she's big. Hey, how's it going, little guy? Oh man, now we got another one. Now get the hell off the road. Come on, cows, get off the road. So we got this cow and her calves here. They won't leave the road. And I don't want to stress her out too much, the cow. And the poor little calves that are getting tuckered out. What's wrong, little guy? Oh, now we got another cow coming here. Oh, she's going to join the party. Stupid cows.
had to talk to those guys for a while. They came through. I don't know if you saw them.
Like a good campsite in there. Jacket off because it was too hot, but I gotta say, she's a little nipply when you're going through these shaded forested areas. Oh, this is pretty. Sure is pretty in here. Hello. Right on. Thank you, sir. Well, that was our coffee break. You want me to get going?
Sure. Wait at the turn.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, see you in a bit. So we had our little coffee break at Steep Creek Camp site. So we are on Steep Creek Road right now, heading east. And we're going to take the turn off to Horseshoe Loop. I don't know if it's actually called Horseshoe Loop, but we named it that because it goes in a horseshoe shape off the main road. And then we're heading back to the trailer. That'll be a bit of a drive, so. And we want to get back to Saskatoon tonight in time for the Rider game on TV. Riders and Argos. It's just been a great day for quadding. We've seen, one, two, three, I think four other groups. Yeah, four other groups for sure. And of all the times I've come into this forest, I've never seen any other quadding groups. But that was probably because I don't come in on the weekends very much. But the few times I have come in on the weekend, I didn't run into anybody. So I think it's getting quite popular. So this little trail will lead us to Horseshoe Loop, and I'm just going to wait here for Corey and Kim. So this is the trail that runs between Steep Creek and the Horseshoe Loop. It's a nice trail. So now we're on the south part of the loop road, or horseshoe loop, or whatever you want to call it. Okay, so we're still on south horseshoe loop, heading east, and this will take us back to the main road, the north-south road. Squirrel! Got a little dusty at the end, eh? Give her?
Feed us at the fork.
Go down Lily Plain and meet you at the junction?
Yeah, where we came out of that first trail.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll meet you there.
Okay. Corey said it's 5 o'clock already. So we want to boogie on back to the truck so we can get back to Saskatoon so we don't miss the Rider game. And if you're not from Canada and you're wondering what the Rider game is all about, that is our football team, our professional football team. It's CFL team, Canadian Football League. And they are the Saskatchewan Roughriders, and they are the number one team in the league right now this year so far. I guess you're not the number one team until you actually win the cup. Man, there's a lot of roads off here that I've never been on before. That was Bear Hill Road, or Trail, whatever you want to call it. Bear Hill Trail, I think it is. And we're headed south, and we are going to be at Cutoff Road pretty soon. There's another junction right, like, only a few yards from where this road meets Cutoff, and that is the Narrows Road Junction where we are parked. That's the one with the water on it and the heavy-duty roller coaster action. Here we go. That's Narrows Road. And that's where we're parked at the end of this one. I gotta wait here for Corey and Kim. And I think they're a ways behind me. I was boogieing pretty fast. That was a bit of film for Wide Open Wilson. If you've if you wanna watch speed driving on a Can-Am, check out Kevin Wide Open Wilson on YouTube. Alright, well, we're on Narrows Road. Heading towards the Beaver Dam. We used to call this Beaver Dam Road because we didn't know it was actually had a name. But there's a sign up that says Narrows Road, so that's what it is. Lots of bear crap on this road. Man, there must be a lot of bears out here. And never seen one. I'm sure they take off as soon as they hear you coming. Cabin.